Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Dear kids, today we are going to complete Surah Al-Mulk. Let's start with ayah number 28. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Qul, say, ara'aytum, have you considered in whether ahlakani Allah, Allah should cause my death, wa man ma'ya, and those with me, aw rahimana, or have mercy upon us. فَمَنْ يُجِيرُ Who can protect الْكَافِرِينَ The disbelievers مِنْ From عَذَاب Punishment أَلِيم Painful Now the whole translation of the ayah will be Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Have you considered whether Allah should cause my death and those with me or have mercy upon us? Who can protect the disbelievers from a painful punishment? Now in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making me clear that it is only His authority who He wants to have mercy on and who He does not want to have mercy on. Now obviously, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not do any zulm. And he will be very just in his decisions. But every human being will only reciprocate what he gave forward. If somebody did good, he is going to be rewarded. And if somebody disobeyed, he is going to face punishment. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam here is being told that you should tell the kuffar that this is in Allah's hands. It is in Allah's hands that whom he punishes and whom he rewards. Even we Muslims cannot be saved from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's punishment without His will. No one can order Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no authority above Him. If He takes a decision, no one can change that decision. He is such a Qadir Rabb. And we have to worship and love Him the most. Now let's see ayah number 29. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ say, هُوَ الرَّحْمَنِ He is the most merciful. آمَنَّا بِهِ We have believed in Him. Wa and عَلَيْهِ Upon Him تَوَكَّلْنَا We have relied. فَسَتَعْلَمُونَ And you will know. مَنْ هُوَ Who it is that فِي is in ضَلَال Error مُبِين Clear. ضَلَال مُبِين In clear error. Now the whole translation of the ayah will be, Say, He is the most merciful. We have believed in Him and upon Him we have relied. And you will come to know who it is that is in clear error. Now in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that at any point in life, if we feel very worried or lonely or we feel like we do not have any good deeds, we should not forget that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahman is the most merciful. He has so much mercy that we cannot even imagine that mercy. We should always say that, Ya Allah, we trust you because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves trust and He loves to be trusted. We should say that we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save us and He will not leave us alone. And this way we don't get hard on ourselves too. We forgive ourselves first and then we expect forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala too because we know that He is Ar-Rahman, the most merciful. And at the end of the ayah, it is mentioned that soon it will be known who is on the right path and who is wrong. On the day of judgment, it will be very clear who is on the right path and who is not. Now let's move on to ayah number 30, which is the last ayah of Surah Al-Mulk. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ say, أَرَأَيْتُمْ Have you considered in if أَصْبَحَ مَاءُكُمْ غَوْرًا If your water was to become sunken, فَمَنْ Then who يَأْتِيكُمْ could bring you بِمَاء with water معين flowing bima'in with flowing water Now the whole translation of the ayah will be say have you considered if your water was to become sunken into the earth then who could bring you flowing water Now, in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us that every blessing that we have is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and no one can bring that blessing back if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself takes it from us. And here he's talking about one special blessing, that is water. Water is a big ni'mah, and we have so much water in the earth. We have water in the oceans, the lakes, the sea, and so many places. And if all this water was to go inside the earth by the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who can bring it back? Just imagine for a second, if all this water goes back into the earth, is sunken into the earth, and there is just no water on the earth to use, then who can bring that water back except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Can someone simply come and bring all the water back and normalize the situation? No, not at all. So we should imagine this to remember that all that we have is because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how great is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahu Akbar. And hence we ought to obey him, and we should not forget to be grateful, and we should do ibadah, and we should do shukr, great, we should practice gratefulness with the use of all the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon us. So that is it for this lesson. Jazakumullahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Zuinat bishahawa.